Good news, good news.
No matter what else is happening in the world.
Always good news, good news.
There is always good news today.
Welcome to Good News Today, the program where you will always find good news, no matter what else is happening in the world. Ephesians chapter 1 is our reading, verses 1 through 5. Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ, by the will of God, to the saints who are in Ephesus and faithful in Christ Jesus. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places in Christ, just as He chose us in Him before the foundation of the world that we should be holy and without blame before Him in love, having predestined us to adoption as sons by Jesus Christ to Himself, according to the good pleasure of His will, to the praise of the glory of His grace, by which He made us accepted in the Beloved.
Since the love of God is shed, priceless blessings on my head, I am made, it is my own. I am delighted in my heart, that if ever may depart, it shall rule.
And we are back for the study portion of our devotional time. I'd mentioned reading Ephesians 1, 1 through 5. I went through verse 6. It just really is a more logical, as it turns out, stopping point for this segment of Paul's epistle to the Ephesian brethren. But let's look at some highlights now of Ephesians chapter 1, 1 through 6. Of course, Paul identifies himself initially as an apostle of Jesus Christ, and he adds, by the will of God. And of course, that really takes us back to something we've talked about before, and that is that he was called to be an apostle by the Lord. On that Damascus road, the Lord appeared to him, not to save him there, as we've talked about before, but that he might be qualified after he was saved, after his conversion, to become an apostle. Well, why did the Lord need to appear to him? Because a qualification of an apostle, one of the qualifications was that he had to have seen the risen Lord, and Paul had not seen the risen Lord before the Lord's ascension back to the Father. So that appearance was for that purpose. But that was later, as he went on into Damascus and did what God told him to do, to wait there for Ananias, who came to him and then told him what to do to become a Christian. And then, after becoming a Christian, he then, of course, became an apostle of Jesus Christ. Now, he says this is addressed to the saints who are in Ephesus and faithful in Christ Jesus. Is he writing to two different groups of people, the saints and the faithful? No, of course not. The saints are the faithful. The faithful are the saints. It's just simply two different ways to express the same group of people. If you're a saint, you're faithful. If you're faithful, you're a saint. In other words, he's writing to Christians because Christians are saints. Saints are Christians. They are one and the same. And then the characteristic greeting that Paul used so often, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Then he begins in verse 3 to talk about the innumerable blessings that are ours if we are Christians. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us. Now, who are the us? Go back to verse 1, in Christ Jesus, the saints and faithful in Christ Jesus. Those who are in Christ Jesus, those are the us to whom he refers in verse 3. To has blessed us, those who are in Christ, in other words, with every spiritual blessing. And then he uses a unique phrase, in the heavenly places in Christ. And the word places there is supplied by the translators. It's not in the original. Literally, the idea of the phrase the heavenly places is literally the heavenlies, the heavenlies. In other words, this is a spiritual realm. I believe it to be Paul's way of referring to the church, to which the faithful, after they obeyed the gospel, were added upon obedience to the gospel of Christ. Then in verse 4, he talks about just as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before him in love. Now, what he's saying here is not that every individual was predetermined or predestined to be saved. No, he's saying that a class of individuals, not the individuals themselves, but a certain class, that class was predetermined. What class is that? Only those who will become holy and without blemish by doing what? By obeying the gospel. In other words, what was predetermined by God was that only those who would ultimately obey the gospel of His dear Son, Jesus Christ, would be those who would become the chosen, or as is elsewhere referred to, the elect. The predestination of the individual is never taught in Scripture, as so many have erroneously concluded. He goes on in verse 5, having predestined us to adoption as sons by Jesus Christ. We've been adopted as with Christ as elder brother by our obedience to the gospel, if we are those who've obeyed the gospel and therefore are in Christ as a result of that. It was according to the good pleasure of His will. He determined that only those who would obey the gospel of His Son would become His children. And so, that's incumbent upon us to do that very thing, to believe that Jesus is the Christ, repent of sins, change our mind about sin, turn from those sins, confess Jesus to be the Christ, and as is clearly taught in Scripture, to be buried in baptism for the remission of sins. Then verse 6, to which we added to our original reading, to the praise of the glory of His grace by which He made us accepted in the Beloved. What's the purpose of our existence? In Christ, to praise God, to bring glory to God and to Christ. And we've been made accepted in the Beloved as a result of our obedience to the gospel for the very purpose that God designed us, created us. He wanted all men to praise and to glorify Him. But only those can do so who are in Christ, having obeyed the gospel of Jesus Christ. Well, that's our devotional time.